Hi, this is Mrs. B with another episode for Schoolish. I promised before that I had a really fun project that was going to incorporate some storytelling, creative writing, even though I'm a social studies teacher. But what I really love about this is you could do anything with it. I can see doing the creative writing aspect, or let's say you're learning about some ancient Greek myths, or you're looking at, I don't know, any type of mythology, any type of traditional story, and it would allow you to recreate that story, learn about it, and then have an extension art activity that is really, really fun and super easy. It can be done in a very short amount of time. I think from start to finish, it took us about 2.5 hours to complete everything, and we didn't do it all at once. We did a little bit at a time. I can also see using the country research project that I had introduced before and doing a theater puppet show explaining about the different things you've learned about a country. So there's a lot of different opportunities to use this. Obviously, with history, you could learn about a historical event and then recreate that. So this is all about storytelling and creative play at home. The first thing you'll notice is that I have a PowerPoint going, a Google slide going in the background to kind of show you the process a little bit more. And I might be moving my image around to make sure that you can see everything. So first of all, where we started wasn't with the actual creating of the theater. We already knew we were going to do this. So you can do this in any step that you want. You can create the theater first as a project on its own, or you can start with the creative writing. We started with the creative writing, and I'm going to provide you with a link to these documents. So here is the front side. This is a creative writing plan, and then this is the visual plan. So I'll go into more detail about that in a slide or two. Just know that you can do that first like we did, or you can start with the creative part first. So what I did is I saved a cereal box. I'm gonna give you a tip. I would use the biggest cereal box that you can get. I wish I would have used a bigger one. I'm gonna make another one because I think ours is a little small. You could even build this out of wood, which I think would be pretty awesome, but what I like about the cereal box is you're repurposing an item that you have, and that is always a plus in my book. So you get the cereal box, and then you are going to cut out a rectangular square on each side. It doesn't have to be perfect. I took a ruler and I made marks in ink, and then I used a little X-Acto knife and I cut it out that way, and it was really easy because guess what? These boxes are very thin, so they're very easy to work with. Next, I had my daughter pick out some paper. Now, you don't even have to do this. You could leave the box the way that it is. You could just use basic construction paper. You could paint it. You could do all different things. We just happened to have a bunch of printed like floral paper, so I let her pick out what she wanted, and we used some decorative scissors, and we cut paper to match all the sides. We glued it down, and then I decided to use Mod Podge to kind of give it a finished look at the end and make sure all the pieces stay glued on nicely, especially because I have a five-year-old and she's gonna be a little bit more rough with it. One step that I didn't get a great picture of was I did glue vellum. I just happen to have vellum. I like crafting, so I have too many crafting things everywhere. You can use a trash bag and it works great. It might even work better than the vellum because the vellum is a little thick. But what I did is I cut a piece of vellum out and then I just used hot glue and I cut down the paper and I glued it in. And so here is our theater. Okay. Here she is doing the work. She was a great helper. Now you'll see the creative story writing and the creation of images. So my husband, who has been a great partner through all of this and helping with homeschooling as I do teaching for my students and all those other things that we have to do to get life done even when we're self-isolating, is he sat down and went over with her that worksheet. You can see it here. And we talked about what stories consist of. There's an opening, an introduction. You get a background of the characters. There is some rising action and events that take place that take you on this journey to the climax, the most important event, the high point of the story. And then the falling action where everything gets resolved, and the ending where you get to find out what happens with all the characters. So her story happens to be, she's obsessed with mermaids, happens to be about a mermaid named Isabella Rose. She lives in Malibu Palace, and she has these magic powers that she didn't know about, and she has magic hair, and she accidentally creates a monster. And so that's her story. The visual plan on the back, I really like for this, because then you start thinking about different components of a story and things like if you were going to be illustrating or presenting, you know, anything visually. So characters, what do they look like, so that we could have an idea of what kind of images would be great for our shadow puppet theater? What is the setting? Where does the story take place? What other important items or objects do we need to make sure that people understand the action in the story? And then action, what symbols or movement represents what takes place, the actions that take place in the story? So we did all of this. And then her and I brainstormed. I happen to have a Cricut because I like to craft. So we went through some images and we picked out images. But you literally could draw images. You could get images from online, just like silhouettes. That's all you need. You could print them and just cut those out. I think having a sturdier cardstock, though, is probably better ultimately because it'll last longer. And then once you've selected the images that you need to tell your story, and do more than you think because you can use them to make up other stories. So what we did is we designed and we picked them out. And then once they were cut out, and I just did it in black, I did it in the darkest cardstock so that it would be the easiest to see. And we glued them on to the back side of all of our cutouts. I used a hot glue gun. I use these skewer sticks. I probably should have just used toothpicks because they ended up being too long and I had to cut them. That's fine. You live and you learn. And then I used a little bit of washi tape to make sure that it stayed secure. And once we got that done, we used a flashlight. I really think it would be awesome to have a clip light so that it can just clip on, because it'd be a lot easier, especially for someone her age, to just have that light right there. So we were just using a flashlight. We're probably going to have to help her a little bit with it, but you can see all of a sudden she can start to tell the story. You know, it takes place at a palace by the sea. There's her mermaid. This is the image to represent her magic hair. And voila, we have created a story. We went ahead and brainstormed all the different things that are important for making a story come to life. Then we created it with our hands, and now we can present it. What I like about this is she's so excited. She wants to tell the story right now to her dad. But I think what we're going to do later is we're going to call her cousin, and we're going to share the story with him. And she'll probably want to share the story with her Nan and Pop and maybe her friends when we have play dates later this week. So that is how you can take a creative writing or even a research project. Like, think about, oh, let's do the French Revolution. Let's do folklore. Let's do, I mean, there's so many, a kid's book, a poem from Shel Silverstein, so many ideas. And it just can actually take your learning to another level and go in a lot of different directions. So I would love to hear what you do. Record it, share it, give me suggestions, and take care of yourselves and each other. Bye. If I can exit, you can hear her in the background.